First is variation in G with height. Height is also called altitude. Height is also called altitude. So variation in G with altitude, because we have seen that acceleration due to gravity varies. Okay, with the different factors. It varies due to shape of Earth. It varies due to distance from the center of Earth, either above or in the downward direction. So whether we go up or down from the surface of Earth, acceleration due to gravity is going to decrease in both the cases, because we know basic formula, small g is gm over r square. Okay, so as it is inversely proportional to distance square, so as the distance increases either in the upward direction or in the downward direction, we don't bother about it. So if the distance increases, then acceleration due to gravity decreases, because it is inversely proportional to square of distance. It's inversely proportional to the square of distance. So for that purpose, we are imagining Earth. This is Earth of mass capital M and radius capital R. There is a point A on the surface of Earth where we have already written acceleration due to gravity. We know on the surface of Earth, acceleration due to gravity is G equal to Gm by R square. Okay, so we have written G equal to Gm by R square at point A. This is equation number one. Okay, we know that we have already derived its expression. If you have any doubt in the formula, derivation of this formula, you can also tell me. But I think last time we did that, right? So now the question is, if we now start going from the surface of Earth, we are standing here. We now start going up from the surface of Earth. So hum planes pe the, suppose hum hills ki taraf ya usse bhi upar jana start ho gaye. So we reached a point B at a height h from the surface of Earth. So hum h height pe from the surface of Earth pahunch gaye at a point B. There, of course, acceleration due to gravity will be different. Let us call it G dash. So acceleration due to gravity at B point is, say, G dash. And let us write its formula also. In place of G, we will write G dash. G and M, they are constant. They will never change. Mass of Earth will not change. Gravitational constant will not change, right? So what will change? Distance from the center of Earth will change. Now, if we take the distance of B point from the center of Earth, it will be R plus H. R plus H will be the distance now. So R plus H whole square. This is equation number two. Okay, this is our equation number two. Yahan tak kisi ko doubt hai ki how we have written R plus H square in place of R square and why we have written G dash in place of G, then you can ask. Yes, students, you can ask them. Puchna hai to puch lo. Is it clear? Okay. Now we divide 2 by 1. Dividing 2 by 1. G dash upon G is Gm over R plus H square over Gm over R square. Gm gets cancelled. Is this step clear? Have a look closely. Pehle humne G likha, phir humne G dash likha, then we divided G dash by G. Capital Gm gets cancelled here. We are left with R square over R plus H square. Right? We are left with R square over R plus H square. So this is the formula first of all. Ye hamara formula aa gaya. Ab kaise pata lagega ki G dash is less than G or more than G? How we will come to know? Since R square is less than R plus H square, kaise pata laga ki ye isse kam hai? Who will tell me? How can we say that R square is less than R plus H square? Yes, how can we say that? Who will tell this? How can we say that r square is less than r plus s square? Who will tell? कैसे पता चला? How will you justify? Raise hand. Yes, students. कैसे पता चला कि r square is less than r plus s square? You all are doing mathematics. You must be knowing. Yes, Divya.
Ma'am, in r square, it is the distance from center of the earth till the surface of the earth. But in r plus h square, there is some height above the surface of earth. So the distance will be more in r plus h square.
Yes. And moreover, we are squaring also. तो जब r में कुछ add कर देंगे, plus h add कर देंगे, उसका square भी कर देंगे, तो वो obviously r square से तो greater ही होगा ना? ठीक है, सो आर स्क्वायर इज डेफिनेटली लेस देन आर प्लस एच स्क्वायर. सो अगर ये इससे कम है, रेशो में ऐसे होता है, अगर ये उससे कम है तो ये भी इससे कम होगा. ठीक है, सो इफ आर स्क्वायर इज लेस देन आर प्लस एच स्क्वायर, जी डैश विल बी लेस देन जी. ठीक है, तो अगर आपको ये आर्टिकल आता है, सिर्फ यहीं पे नहीं छोड़ देना, मैथमेटिक्स करके छोड़ दिया, जी डैश निकाल दिया, आपने कमेंट करना है. क्वेश्चन इज How does small g vary with height? तो उस क्वेश्चन का आंसर आपने देना है कि with height acceleration due to gravity goes on decreasing. ठीक है, it decreases with height. आपको इसका आंसर देना है. That acceleration due to gravity decreases with height. So is this article clear to you? Derivation clear to you? Yes, Lisa.
Ma'am. जो ये डेरिवेशन है वो स्ट्रेट वे एग्जाम में आ सकती है, पूरी डेरिवेशन?
यस, आ सकती है. आई थिंक आपको हमने एक आध बार पेपर में ये सेट किया भी हुआ है क्वेश्चन, और या टेस्ट में भी डाला हुआ है एज सच इन द फॉर्म ऑफ आर्टिकल ऑल्सो. ठीक है, ओके. आफ्टर दिस नेक्स्ट इज वेरिएशन इन जी विद डेप्थ. वेरिएशन इन जी विद डेप्थ. नाउ वी स्टार्ट गोइंग इनसाइड द अर्थ. ठीक है, हमने एक टनल डिग कर दी, यहां से टनल डिग कर दी, वी स्टार्टेड गोइंग इनसाइड द अर्थ नाउ. ठीक है, नाउ व्हाट विल हैपन, सी. सो वेरिएशन इन जी विद डेप्थ, वेरिएशन इन जी विद डेप्थ नाउ. सो अगेन वी आर टेकिंग अर्थ. अर्थ सेंटर ऑफ अर्थ इज O, mass of earth is m and radius of earth yahan se leke yahan tak is r. So at point A, because distance of point A from center of earth is r, we can write at A point G is gm by r square. Theek hai, yahan tak to wahi hai, beginning is the same. But now we will say that as we go inside the earth, this is a different situation as compared to when we go up from the surface of earth. Why the two situations are different? Uska reason ye hai, because when we go in the air upwards, to hum air hamare raste mein aa rahi hai, uski density 1 hoti hai, 1 kg per meter cube. But when we are going inside the earth, we encounter so many rocks and so much material of earth. Earth is having a large density which can't be ignored. So when we were going up, we had written the expression in terms of mass only. We use this expression as such. But when we are taking depth, we are going in the interior of Earth, we can't ignore it. Okay? Then we can't ignore this density of Earth. So first of all, we have to modify our expression. Okay? First of all, we have to modify our expression, right? We will have to express this mass in terms of density. Hame mass ko density ki terms mein express karna padega. Theek hai? So let us do that. You know the formula of density? Density of earth is mass of earth over volume of earth, right? Cross multiply mass of earth can be written as volume into density. Now, if we say that Earth is a sphere of radius r, then what will be its volume? 4 over 3 pi r cube. So, volume of Earth is 4 over 3 pi r cube. We get mass now in terms of density. So, हमारा ये जो g का formula है, ये density की terms में होना चाहिए. So, let us put this m here now. ठीक है, पुट दिस वैल्यू ऑफ m हियर, g और r स्क्वायर ऐसे ही रहेंगे, सो g ओवर r स्क्वायर एंड मास इज 4 ओवर 3 पाई r क्यूब रो d, 2 r's गेट कैंसल्ड, वी गेट 1, सो स्मॉल g इज 4 ओवर 3 पाई g r d. This was equation number 1, this is equation number 2. Now this formula of g we will be using. Okay, this formula of g we will use now. Is that clear? Fine. Great. So after that, now we were standing here. अब हमने tunnel dig की और हम अर्थ के अंदर जाना शुरू हो गए. We reached a point B. तो हमारी डेप्थ कितनी है, सरफेस से हम कितनी डेप्थ पे चले गए, डेप्थ सरफेस से लेंगे, ठीक है, बट एट बी पॉइंट व्हाट वाज इट्स डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द सेंटर ऑफ अर्थ, क्योंकि जी लिखने के लिए बी पॉइंट पे वी नीड दिस मच डिस्टेंस ऑलवेज फ्रॉम द सेंटर ऑफ अर्थ, सो इफ इफ दिस इज डी, दिस होल वॉज आर, हाउ मच इज दिस आर माइनस डी, सो दिस डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द center of earth is r minus b and acceleration due to gravity at b point is g dash. Okay, acceleration due to gravity at point b is g dash. Is that okay now? Okay, koi doubt hai toh? So let us write now at point b, in place of g we will write g dash, 4 over 3 pi capital g, they are all constants, वो बी पॉइंट पे भी वही रहेंगे, ठीक है, सिर्फ डिस्टेंस चेंज होगा, पहले आर था अब डिस्टेंस आर माइनस बी, सो इन प्लेस ऑफ आर वी विल पुट आर माइनस बी, अर्थ की डेंसिटी भी वही रहेगी, सो वी विल टेक द डेंसिटी ऑफ अर्थ आल्सो टू बी द सेम, सो दिस इज आवर इक्वेशन नंबर 3, हैव अ लुक. Okay, so this is g dash, this is g, dividing now, dividing 3 by 2, dividing 3 by 2, we get g dash over g is 4 over 3 pi g r minus d d or over 4 over 3 pi g r d. तो ये कैंसल आउट हो गया, 4 ओवर 3 पाई जी कैंसल आउट हो गया, सो वी आर लेफ्ट विद जी डैश ओवर जी इज आर माइनस डी ओवर आर, आर माइनस डी अपॉन आर, ठीक है, ये जी उधर ले जाइए, जी डैश और आर माइनस डी को हम लिख सकते हैं बेस सेपरेट करके, आर माइनस आर ओवर डी ओवर आर इंटू जी, आर ओवर आर वन हो गया, so we get new acceleration due to gravity, g dash is 1 minus d over r into g, so this is new g, and agar hum bracket open karte hain to it is g minus something, g mein se kuch minus ho raha hai, that means this acceleration due to gravity is also less, so whether we go up or down from the surface of earth, acceleration due to gravity will decrease, theek hai, acceleration due to gravity is going to decrease only. So have a look at the whole derivation. Ye wale steps clear hai aapko? R minus d over r. Then in the next step, hum g ko udhar le gaye, base separate kar liye. R over r cancel hoke 1 ho gaya. 1 minus d over r, theek hai, into g. So this is our variation in g with the depth. Have a look at the whole derivation once and ask if there is any doubt. चलिए अब ये दोनों डेरिवेशंस आज आप लिख कर देख लो एंड फिक्स इन योर माइंड, तो कल आप मुझसे पूछ लेना अगर अभी कोई डाउट होगा आपको, राइट, देन कल हम रिवाइज करेंगे वर्क एनर्जी थ्योरम की डेरिवेशंस, राइट, नाउ लेट अस सी व्हाट द स्टूडेंट्स हैव डन नाउ, राइट, यस, yes, so there are two nuts and attached to the bottom cap of this bottle with the help of rubber bands, yes, Then after this, you will allow this bottle to fall. So what happens, Titiksha? What did you observe?
Ma'am, they fall with a very high speed.
Nuts fall inside the bottle. What do you observe?
Yes.
Okay.
Nuts fall inside the bottle in a very high speed.
Okay. So what do you say? What must have happened? So here, very good effort, Titiksha. So what must have happened here is, Titiksha, would you like to explain or shall I?
Ma'am, you please, okay. I don't know.
Okay. So what is happening here is that as the rubber bands are attached to the nuts, rubber bands are stretched. So they store potential energy in them, right? So when the bottle is allowed to fall down, that potential energy is converted into kinetic energy. Okay, and they fall inside. Second concept that we can relate is acceleration due to gravity or gravity. So under their weight, the nuts, they will fall inside the bottle. Okay, as down as they can go. So two concepts together you can apply here. One is conversion of potential energy into kinetic energy, as she is saying that speed is very fast. So that potential energy must have been converted into kinetic energy that is giving it high speed. And second thing is that under gravity, under the weight, they will get detached from the ends and automatically fall into the bottle, right? Okay. So see, there is a straw and there are two threads and two stones are attached, one big and one small. So first you see the stick was horizontal, it was balanced. Now when she dipped inside the glasses of water, then you will see that the small stone is at greater depth. And if you look at the stick now, it's tilted towards the smaller weight. It's tilted towards the smaller weight. Okay, so that is tilted towards the smaller weight. So can Jia tell me how it is happening? What did you learn from this experiment? Which mass is at the lower side?
And yes. Instead of that heavier rock, the rock that had less mass went down.
So what is the reason? What is the reason behind this? The stone that has greater mass has displaced more water. According to Archimedes principle, we did the practical that day. तो जिसका वेट ज्यादा होगा वो ज्यादा वेट लूज करेगा, ठीक है? इट विल डिस्प्लेस मोर अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर, सो दैट मींस इट विल रिसीव मोर अपथ्रस्ट इनसाइड वाटर. सो द हैवी स्टोन विल रिमेन अप एंड द स्मॉलर स्टोन विल गो डाउन. इट विल रिसीव लेस बाइंड फोर्स, इट विल रिसीव लेस अपथ्रस्ट. सो दैट्स व्हाई यू कैन से दिस इज इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद योर आर्किमिडीज प्रिंसिपल एक्सपेरिमेंट, राइट? So students, now I'm going to share two more activities. You see those two activities also very useful for you. They will be. Yes. So this is an activity based on work energy and power. Okay, work energy and power. Look at this activity one carefully. Recall the definition potential energy to compute energy contained in a body by virtue of its motion. Okay, we need one plastic bottle, rubber bands, nut, scissors and matchstick. All the things are available at home. Make a hole in the bottle lid and also in its base. See in the diagram. You will again make a hole in the bottle lid and base may be a hole kar dena, theek hai? Slip a long rubber band in a heavy hex nut वही जैसे तितिक्षा ने नट्स लिए थे वैसे ही एक नट लेके उसमें से आपने रबर बैंड पास करवा के एक नॉट टाई कर देनी है. कट अ स्लिट इन द बॉटल टू स्लिप इन द हेक्स नट एंड रबर बैंड. तो उसमें आप एक स्लिट के थ्रू नट को अंदर कर दोगे बॉटल के, वो साइड पे एक स्लिट बनी हुई है ना देखी, तो उससे आप रबर बैंड को अंदर उसके पहुंचा दोगे बॉटल के अंदर. अटैच द लेफ्ट एंड ऑफ रबर बैंड विद अ मैच स्टिक टू द लिड एंड पुल द अदर एंड एंड फिक्स इट टू द बेस ऑफ बॉटल विद अ मैच स्टिक. तो दूसरे को आपने मैच स्टिक की हेल्प से बेस से कनेक्ट कर देना है और जो फर्स्ट एंड था उसको मैच स्टिक से लिड के साथ लगा देना, मतलब वहां फिक्स हो जाएगा ना लिड. अगर आप मैच स्टिक यूज करोगे तो वो टाइट हो जाएगा. ठीक है, लेट द नट बी हैंगिंग, तो नट बीच में हैंग कर रहा है. नाउ रोल द बॉटल ऑन द ग्राउंड. अब आपने बॉटल को ग्राउंड पे रोल कर देना है. ठीक है, सो व्हाट विल यू ऑब्जर्व, आपने अपनी ऑब्जर्वेशन शेयर करनी है. व्हाट डिड यू ऑब्जर्व, व्हाई डिड द बॉटल कम बैक. आपको ये आइडिया हो ही जाएगा कि बॉटल वापस भी आनी शुरू हो जाएगी जो कि एक्सपेक्टेड नहीं था. What is the relation between potential energy and kinetic energy? So why this is happening? You have to make it out. ठीक है? तो the second activity, you will take a nut and tie one end of the string around the nut. बस उसको tie कर देना है और उसको आप air में suspend करोगे by holding another end of string. ठीक है, आप उसको मतलब नेकलेस की तरह थ्रेड को उसमें से टाई करोगे एंड यू विल होल्ड इट विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ स्केल एज दे हैव शोन. लिफ्ट द नट इन द एयर एंड लीव इट. पहले आप उसको थोड़ी हाइट से छोड़ो, देन लिफ्ट द नट अ लिटिल हायर दिस टाइम एंड अगेन लीव इट. ओके, नाउ लीव इट फ्रॉम अ हायर हाइट, फ्रॉम अ ग्रेटर हाइट एंड अगेन लीव इट. यू हैव टू आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन, विच एनर्जी डिड द नट पोजेस व्हेन लिफ्टेड इन एयर. After leaving the nut, in which energy is potential energy converted? Why did it slow down later? And in which case A or B nut started moving faster and why? तो उन्होंने आपको बता ही दिया कि बाद में स्लो भी हो जाएगा और कौन सा स्लो होगा ये आपको देखना. ठीक है, सो दे हैव गिवन अ लॉट ऑफ हिंट हियर. ओके, नाउ यू टेल मी हु विल डू दिस. टेक अ स्क्रीन शॉट स्टूडेंट्स एंड हु विल डू दिस. हरी अप, इमीडिएटली रेज योर हैंड. आई हैव टू take attendance as well. Hurry up, jaldi se bolo. Yes students, 9th D, come on, 9th D class.